Hello, welcome to all my dear students to this online lecture. Today's our topic or our subject is a computer and I am your computer teacher. As you know, my name is Shweta Yadav and today's our topic that we continue study thesis the WordPad topic. In this lectures also we study the WordPad and I hope this is our last lecture for this topic. From the next lecture, we continue the new topic, new program with interesting ideas. So now see, in the previous lecture, what we study. Before starting our lecture, I hope you all are fine. Take care of yourself, stay home and stay safe. If you're not covering your mouth with the mask, then please cover your mouth with the mask. Wash your hand continuously with alcohol-based hand drop and avoid the close contact who has a flu-like symptoms. Okay? Now see, in the previous lecture, what we have studied, what we have learned. So, in the previous lecture, the first that we study that how to open the WordPad program. Right? First point that we study in the previous lecture, that is how to open the WordPad program. So tell me how to open the WordPad, because you learn in two lecture we continue study that how to open the WordPad program, and I think you are trying at your home. If you are having the computer at your home or another laptop you also have, so please do with me, make practice in computer so you can study computer very well. See, this is a practical subject, computer, so you must have to do practically. If you are not having a computer, then it's okay, but if you are having at your home, so please make sure that you have minimum 30 minutes in your computer. Do something in a computer for writing, for painting. Yes, this all topic that we can learn. So you know easily then what is the use of the WordPad, what is the use of the paint. And now the third program we have learned, the WordPad, right? So please learn. If you are do this, then your computer knowledge will become improve. So now see the second topic, how to format the font. Right, we can see that we have to change the size of the font, we have to change the style of the font. If we want to do darker font, then we use the bold tool. If we have to write in an italic style, so we have italic also tool, underline tool also we have, right? We have the another option for size increment, decrement, the A letter. We have a color tool to change the font color also, black, white, green, yellow, right? Now see, third, how to give a style to font. We also study this. We have a one dialog box. We have to just press the left mouse button, then it will be open. It's so easy, right? So we have to just click one from the mouse and the dialog box will be open, and we have to just select our font style that we want, right? Now the fourth one, how to format our paragraph. We also done that. We written a one paragraph of capital letter, small letter, full stop, comma, right? We can done this thing. In this lecture we can also write one paragraph with the special symbols, so you can learn something new also. Now see here the pictures. This is the picture. See, we have written here the WordPad in the search tab, then the WordPad program, it will be open. So now see here the WordPad icon, the A letter, notebook, we can see here. So at the symbols, the icon suggests the name WordPad. It is used for writing. What? It is used for writing, right? Now see the another picture, that is, it's written the word pad program, we return something here, we can do something in the word pad program for writing letter, paragraph, numbers, formatting anything, add pictures also. These all things we can do in the word pad program. Correct? We can do this all thing in the word pad program. In the previous lecture, we used these tools also, size increment tools, style, bold, italic, underline. You can see here the increment of font size, decrement of font size. Here is the change the font color, the capital A letter, and here is the pencil for highlighting our text. These all tools we can learn in the previous lecture, correct? Yes, we can learn this all tool in the previous lecture. Now see, in this lecture what we have to study. So the first that we have to study is how to add the pictures. I think in the previous lecture we can also done, but now see, in this lecture we can learn deeply that how to add the pictures, how to write paragraphs. These simple two topics, the last topic of WordPad, we have to learn in this lecture. So the WordPad program chapter is over here. So now see, I am opening the WordPad window. You can see the notepad window. Now see, this is our WordPad window, as you can see here, right? This is our WordPad window for what? For what? Writing letters, numbers, paragraph. Yes, these all things we can write. So what is the first use of the WordPad? Tell me, what is the first use of the WordPad? See, I am written. Is the use of WordPad program? Question mark. So this question mark is a special symbol, right? The question mark is the special symbol. Once wait, I am opening the keyboard. If we have a virtual keyboard, so we can open it and you can see that how we choose the keys, right? How we choose the key. See, here is the virtual keyboard. Now see, question mark, you can see here the question mark. Yes, so question mark is the upside of the key. For example, I am simply pressing these, so question mark is not written, but what? The sign, the division sign is show here. Why? Because here in the one key we have a both symbol key, question mark and this slash or division sign. But I want to write here a question mark because I am asking the question, right? Because I am asking the question, so I want to write here only question mark, not the slash or division sign. So again I am erasing it with the help of the backspace key. Now see, shift key, you can see here I am pressing the shift key. Here the blue color is display that I am pressing the shift key. Now I am pressing this key, question mark. So you can see here the question mark is written. See? So for upside of symbols we have to write. So we use our shift key and this key. Both at a time we have to press. So then and then the question mark will be written. Now press the enter key comes in the next line and write the answer. Now see, after answer I want to put a comma. So come here and comma is here, but see, here is the one is a semicolon and upside is the comma. So we want upside symbol, that comma. So again the press the shift key and from the another hand press this key. So see here the comma is written, right? So now tell me, what is the answer? What is the use of the WordPad program? Who give me answer? Tell me fast. Give me the answer. What is the use of the WordPad program? WordPad is used to write numbers, comma, see, comma. So where is the comma? Here is the comma. Where is the comma? Here is the comma. So comma is the bottom of the key and upside we have a less than sign. You can see here the comma and this less than sign. So we just simply click this because the comma is the bottom of the key. If we want to this sign, the less than sign, then we used shift key, then press. But now we just simply pressing because we just want a comma and comma is at the bottom of the key, and if the symbol is the bottom of the key, then we don't use a shift key. We just simply press this key. Comma, then numbers, then letters, then again comma, so press here, and then for paragraph writing, yes, paragraph writing, right? Then add pictures, right? For adding a pictures, for adding the pictures, right? This is the use of the WordPad program. And the last of the answer we put a full stop. So tell me first, where is the full stop from the keyboard? Here. And full stop is the bottom of the key, so we just simply press, then the full stop it comes here, right? So what is the use of the WordPad program? The WordPad is used to write numbers, letters, paragraph for adding the pictures. So easy answer, right? Now press the enter key from the keyboard and come to the next line. And the second question that you have to tell me, where is a style command? Where is the style tool that give to the font to change the style? So tell me from the ribbon, this is our ribbon, tell me there, where is this tool to give the font style? Tell me where is this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, or this one? I think this one. So this tool is for changing the font style, right? For changing the font style. For example, we are selecting this answer and we have to change this answer like this. No, it's not like good. So I will have to change another one, this one, and bold, underline, and big letter, increasing the font style. See, we are changing the font formatting with the help of only this area. This is area of formatting the font. For changing the style, for changing the size, increment, decrement of the size, for highlighting. For example, we have to highlight this question of this color. So What is the use of the WordPad program? The question is highlighted with the yellow color. What with the yellow color? Right? So you can understanding the WordPad program clearly. So now you have to make a practice at your home. Right? You have to make the practice at your home. So please do it regularly. Right? Now see, come to the next line and now write one paragraph. Write one paragraph, right? See, we are writing one paragraph, okay? So start. What we have to write related to school, our school, yes? Okay, now see, we have to write paragraph related to school. So write, first of all, we have to change here that the selected, the bold style and the underline, and the font we have also changed because we are writing a paragraph. So another new, right? Another new topic. So we have to must remember that we have to change the selected style if we are writing the new topic, new thing. So school tab is the place where we learn to read and write, and full stop. It is the most, MOST, most critical place right it is the most critical place for a students, correct, comma, and it helps, what, it helps us to learn new things. Full stop again, because the second sentence is also complete. Then third line, the teacher, see here is the teacher spelling mistake, so I am correcting it. Teachers are always helpful and teach, see again mistake, teach spelling, so correcting, teachers important things, correct, in a life. Teachers are always helpful and teachers important things in life. It is the correct sentence or not? Tell me, your teacher is always helping you or not? And teach important things in a life. Correct? We must always be regular. We must always be regular to school. WOL school, as missing classes. What? Classes can lead to problem. ड्यूरिंग एग्जाम्स एंड फुल स्टॉप. आई थिंक इट्स डन. द फोर लाइन पैराग्राफ इट्स डन. नाउ रीड अगेन विथ मी. स्कूल इज प्लेस वेयर हियर. स्कूल इज द प्लेस वेयर वी लर्न टू रीड एंड राइट. इट इज द मोस्ट क्रिटिकल प्लेस फॉर स्टूडेंट कॉमा एंड इट इज हेल्प अस टू लर्न न्यू थिंग्स फुल स्टॉप. द टीचर्स आर ऑलवेज हेल्पफुल एंड टीचर्स इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग्स इन लाइफ फुल स्टॉप. We must always be regular to school as missing classes can lead to problem during exams. Correct? So it is the simple paragraph we have written here. But now see, we have to format it. We are just simply written. What we just roughly simply written, but now we have to format this paragraph. We have to format these paragraphs. So how we done it? First of all, I want to change the size of the font. Suppose I have to increase this much, so I will increase. Then the color I have to change to this. I think is this? No. The another so light. Oh. Come to the blue. Blue is the correct color for boys, right? For boys is blue color is the correct and for girl pink color is the correct. So which I have to choose? Blue or pink? For girls or for boys? I think we choose a both color. The first three line for girls and then last four line for boys. We choose the both. So we in the one paragraph we have a different font color. Now see. At the center we have to written, at the left we have to written, at the right we have to written. Sorry, left have to written or right. So always remember that the paragraph we have to write from the left hand side. What? The left hand side. So we have always started the paragraph from the left side. So now also justify. See, the justify, it means the lines are starting and the ending with the same here. Spacing, see the difference. I am choosing the 1.0, now 1.15. So here the spacing is increasing. You can see the difference, 1.5, the spacing improving. 2, so it come more. It come more. You can see the paragraph have a more space, right? Now see, school is the place, but I have to write the S in the small, but here is the mistake. The first letter of the paragraph we always have to written in a capital letter. So first of all, where is our keyboard? Here. From the keyboard we have to press here and press a backspace and it is the S letter. Now press the caps lock key and write S. So here S is in a big letter, the capital letter. Now again off the caps lock key. Now see the another change, learn to. Here is the mistake, the space is not given, so come here and give the space. Now here is the full stop. It is the new sentence. Now here also mistake, I is written in the small, but the new sentence that we started in the paragraph also we have to written the first letter in the capital. What? The first letter in the capital. So it is it I, and on caps lock press the I, of caps lock. Now it is correct. It is the most curricle. Come here, give the space, place for a student. Here is the comma, right? So we have to just press, the comma is given here. But we have already one comma, so second we have to erase it. Now, and it is help us to learn new thing. Here is a mistake. After the full stop, we have to give a space. T is written in a capital. So, T written in a capital. Teachers always helpful and teachers the important thing in the life. Here we also we written in a capital big letter. We must always be regular to school as missing the classes can lead to problem during the exam. What if we are missing our school, if we are missing our classes, then it is problem during if your exam. If your exam is coming and if you are not conducting the lecture, then you not learn something new, then how you write in a paper. So you have to must regular in the school. For now, we don't have come to school, so we are learning online teaching, right? So it is not that you have to not come school, so you are not learning. You must have to learn at your home. If you are not coming at your school, it's okay, but you don't stop learning. You have to learn always. Every day you have to learn new. So your knowledge will improve. Yes, so remind that you have to always learn something new. You have to must practice your main subjects, maths, English, science. Do regular classes, do attend regular classes, do your homework, also give a test. Yes, do this all thing. If you are not coming at your school, it doesn't mean you don't have to learn. You have to learn. So, keep going, keep moving, keep learning. So, this is the paragraph that we written here, correct? Now see, we have to add a picture. So, come here, the picture tool. You have to see here the picture tool and click picture tool, right? In the picture tool, we have to add the pictures. We have to add the pictures, right? So this topic we can learn in the next lecture. Here is one disadvantage that you can see. For example, I am choosing these pictures and opening it. See, the picture is open here, right? The good morning image, it will open here, but the one mistake, if I want to write inside the picture, yes, inside the picture, so it cannot written. We are not adding the text in the pictures. So here is the main disadvantage of WordPad, then we cannot write in the image, in the behind of image or in the front of the image. For example, in the image, we here is the written good morning. In the same, if we want to write, we can write, but we have to use another program. What? We have to write these things in the another program. So we use another program in the next lecture. The new topic, this problem automatically solve. So here we are inserting the image. What? Inserting the image. You can see here the one frame we are choosing here. So this one advantage is only that we are not adding here text. In the picture, we cannot write anything. But we have another option also. Computer give another option also for this. For example, we have to write in this frame flower picture. So we can write. But we have to use the another program. So सी. ओके, सो दिस इज अ न्यू कंसेप्ट. इन द इमेज वी हैव टू राइट न्यू थिंग्स. सो दिस न्यू कंसेप्ट वी कैन लर्न इन द न्यू प्रोग्राम. द नेम इज द माइक्रोसॉफ्ट ऑफिस वर्ड दैट वी लर्न इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. सो टुडेज अवर लेक्चर इज स्टॉप हियर. बाय एवरीवन, टेक केयर, स्टे होम, स्टे सेफ.